गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एंड यू आर एंजॉयिंग द ऑनलाइन लर्निंग एंड यू आर जस्ट शोइंग योर रिस्पॉन्स शोइंग योर इंटरेस्ट इन योर ऑनलाइन लर्निंग एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू सी द परफॉर्मेंस दोज हू आर सेंडिंग मी द वर्क एंड दोज हू आर पुटिंग देयर क्वेरीज. सो नाउ दिस इज द टाइम टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर. That is LibreOffice base. Okay, so first of all, I will tell you what is database. This chapter is about database. Need for a database. Why do we need database? Children, see, when we have some information and we just speak it like this only, without any arranging of information or without any kind of distribution. So what we feel, sometimes we get confused, na? So database is a way to show the information in grouping means in different fields, so that we can have the information and we can understand the meaning of those information very clearly, and we can compare also. So for all these we use database. Basically, what is database? Database is basically a management of data or information. See, database is an organized collection of data generally stored and accessed electronically from a computer system. Clear? So database management system is the software that interacts with end users, application and the database itself to capture and analyze the data. So we are going to start the chapter about database. So look here on my pointer. In every organization, there are quantities of data that need to be tracked efficiently. Tracked means recorded. Using a paper filing system, text document, or even a spreadsheet to keep track of valuable information is not sufficient. Means the paper documentation is not sufficient. Data must be stored in an organized way, and users must be able to get specific information in the form of reports and queries from it. If we fill the data on paper only and we do the documentation on the paper and we are keeping our records on paper, so it will not be sufficient. We should organize the data in a very presentable manner, okay, or in the form of reports or queries. A database system is a solution which can do all data management effectively and efficiently. So, database system is a system which can arrange or manage the data effectively or efficiently. So, let's move. What is database? A database is an organized way of storing data and record keeping in a computer. Basically, it is the arrangement of record, or basically it is a presentation of record in an effective way in the computer. Database offers an organized mechanism. See what all things we can do in database: storing, managing, retrieving information. The information is organized in such a way that a computer program can quickly find and select the desired pieces of data. So here, what is the purpose of database? The purpose of database is to organize the data in such a way that a computer program can quickly find it and select the desired field or desired part of data. See, data is basically the record, the field, okay? About database management system. Database management system is also known as DBMS. Short form of database management system is DBMS. So the DBMS is a computer program which provides facilities. See, which all facilities it provides add, to modify or to delete data from the database, ask queries, ask questions about the data stored in the database, and produce report summarizing selected contents. So these all tasks are performed under this management system, that is DBMS. See the example, popular DBMS softwares are Oracle, Microsoft Office Access 2007 and FoxPro. These are some popular DBMS software, children. So you have to keep them in your mind. Now come on, what is relational database? We are going to study here relational database. The relational database consists of, see what all things you will find in this database. You will find field, record, tables. See, these are records. Is she age 6, age 14, and she is in 8th class. This is a record of is she. Okay. And field, what is field? Age. Age is a field here. Class is a field here. And name is a field here. And what is a table? This complete set of information which is categorized under different groups, it is called table. So tables are building blocks of a database, and all the data is managed in tables consisting of rows. See children, these are rows. Arun 15 9, Ishi 14 8, Sebi 16 10, Shalini 14 8. These are rows, and class, age, names, these are fields. These are fields. So this is a field, this is column, age is column, class is in different column, and these are rows. Fine. Now come on. A field is a single piece of information, like Arun, like 14, like 8. And record is one complete set of fields, like Ishi. Ishi's age is 14 and Ishi is in 8th class. Now come on number 3. A table is a collection of records. These all records are comes under a table. Table is a collective record of information. So these all records, these all fields are collectively known as table. Fine. Now come move down. Advantages of a database. With my lecture, it is very much clear that what are the advantages of database. To know the advantages of database, it is essential to know how ordinary file system work. And ordinary file system has a lot of disadvantages, like duplication of data, data vulnerability, data inconsistency, etc. So to overcome all these problems, we take help of database, which is superior to these ordinary file system. So it has a number of advantages, that's why we use it, this database. So what are the advantages? Number one is reduces data redundancy. Here means the duplicacy is reduced here. In a database system, some data only needs to be entered once, and then it is available to all other files. It reduces the problem of duplication of data and hence reduces data redundancy. For example, you need to enter employee ID and name of employees only once in a file, and rest of the file can pick the employee name from this file by establishing their link to the field employee ID. So by establishing the link to the previous file, the same data can be copied. So there is no need to put the same data, same field again and again. So it reduces the data redundancy means reduces the copying of data again and again. And second is improves data security. Children, in database, our data is secure. There is 100% security of our data. So the database management system improves security of our informations and our records. The database can limit the access only to authorized users. So if it is bound to authorized users, the another person cannot change or edit the fields for adding, editing, deleting, viewing the records. For example, in an employee table, the salary field can be accessed only by the accounts department. Any person from other department cannot alter any kind of information in this. So, and can be updated only by the higher management personnel. So, our data is 100% secure here. Okay, the data related to specific field can be altered by the heads or the higher management of that specific field. So, it is very, very good point for which due to this we use the database management system. It removes the data inconsistency. When the data is updated in a database, everybody can access the same updated data, as no separate files are maintained for the same set of data. For example, when a new employee joins or an existing employee leaves the organization, addition and deletion of those particular employees from the master file is done and changes are reflected in all other files. See, it is little bit that related to the first point where I told you that it copied the data from the previous file by creating the links. Okay, so here also, if some changes are made in the master file, the same changes are followed by the other files, okay, which consists the record of employees. So it removes the data inconsistency also. Maintains data integrity. So you have to understand here the data integrity. So listen carefully. While entering the data, correctness of the data can be ensured by applying suitable data type and the appropriate data validation check. So it is the validation checks are applied on the data to see the purity, we can say, to see the correctness of the data. For example, when we enter the detail of a candidate interviewed in an organization, one can ensure that the age of the candidate whose record is being entered is always within the prescribed age limit for recruitment. Means here the limitations will be given, okay, and the data track will not go beyond the limitations. Clear? If the age is specified that the employee should be of till 27th of year, 27 year, the age of the employee, age of the candidate should be, last limitation is 27 years, so it will not go beyond it. So here the validation check will be applied, or it will be applied on the employees, the candidate's detail. So what can be avoided here? Here the field which we are filling that cannot go beyond the limitations. So here limitations are fixed and the validation checks are also applied. So data integrity is maintained in proper form. Clear? So make reporting easier. See, when we are creating the database, the reporting is very, very easy, and the comparison of different field is also very, very easy, because the data is organized here in an effective way. So it is very easy to understand.